Put your hands behind your back.
No, they're going to take me to jail.
Stop.
Please.
Stop.
You want?
Dad, help me.
I am not helping you.
Please help me.
Well, he attacked me with a screwdriver and he beat me on the face.
I'm not doing anything. No.
Yeah, not anything.
Natalie, you lied to me.
You're the problem.
No, you're the problem.
You're going to beat me up?
No, I'm not walking out this house without my shoes.
La mayoría de los padres nunca soñarían con llamar a la policía para denunciar a sus hijos, pero en algunos casos extremos las cosas se salen tanto de control que no queda otra opción que involucrar a las autoridades. Analizaremos altercados violentos y demenciales que estallaron debido a un control remoto de televisión, padres que llamaron a la policía para denunciar a sus hijos por negarse a salir de su automóvil y casos en los que hijos drogadictos ponen en peligro a sus propios padres. Asegúrate de tener tus palomitas de maíz listas y ponte cómodo mientras contamos algunos de los dramas familiares más desquiciados. Hijo drogadicto. Todas las familias tienen problemas, pero a veces se agravan tanto que los padres sienten la necesidad de llamar a la policía. El 24 de julio de 2023, la policía local de Ohio respondió una llamada sobre un altercado doméstico entre un padre y su hijo. Los oficiales llegaron al lugar, pero las cosas comenzaron de inmediato con dificultades. Ambos estaban bastante alterados y ante la policía tenían la tarea de averiguar qué sucedió en este tenso altercado. El hijo explicó que su abuela acababa de fallecer, por lo que había mucha agitación en la familia. Aunque estaba relativamente sereno, su padre estaba mucho más alterado. Estaba bastante agitado y no estaba muy tranquilo con los oficiales, o incluso se quejaba de tener que esperarlos media hora.
Hey, dude, I ain't got. I didn't do shit. Whoa.
We're hacking down for weapons.
Okay.
What happened tonight?
Oh, y'all woke up after a whole day.
Come over here and talk to me.
No, I'll talk to you right here.
Well, I don't want to talk to you next to him. All right, what's going on?
So I want to do.
I see what I see.
He's out there in his truck. I got out on dope and I walked up to him and smacked him in his chest about 10 times. The wake his up and he jumped up one fight.
Jumped up one.
Hey, don't talk to him. Talk to me.
Man, this is.
We gotta figure it out.
Because it's getting twisted around. Dude,
that's why I'm talking to you.
I worked all day yesterday.
Yeah, that's why I'm talking to you.
After I got off work, I had to go to my parents' house or my grandmother's house because she just passed away.
Yeah.
And we cleaned
up. Sorry to hear that.
We got up this morning and went and. Walked out to my grandma's house and finished stuff up that we needed to get picked up.
Okay. So he woke you up and what happened?
Woke me up, jerked me out of bed, man.
Jerked you out of bed?
Yeah, saying that I've been laying around so high, so long that I must be high and this, that, and the other. No, dude, I'm grieving so hard right now. My grandma just passed away.
Are you gonna calm down?
I'm not. I'm upset, sir.
Okay. Well, if you calm down, we can help you.
Well,
we're here to help you.
I will try to calm down, sir.
All right. I understand that you're hurt. I see you got a... would you like a medic? Would you like
I would not.
Okay. Are you sure? You got a pretty good gash.
I'm good.
All right. I'm just asking.
He got my glasses, I guess.
Okay.
I don't know.
Did he break them?
I don't know.
You don't know?
He broke my doors.
Okay. All right. Well, all right. We're getting
somewhere. I'm waiting on you guys for 30 minutes.
We are coming. Lights and sirens.
I'm sorry to stand up. I'll hold my hands like this.
We are coming.
I waited on you guys for 30 minutes while this maniac's beating on my doors.
We came as fast as we could, sir.
What am I supposed to do?
All right.
Am I supposed to not be upset?
Just calm down.
Huh? Am I supposed to not be upset?
Calm down. But we're here to help you, but you need to calm down if you want us to help you.
I don't know. I don't know if I agree with your help or not.
There's three of us. All three of us are here. We were all around the county. I'm sorry it took us 30 minutes to get here, but we came lights and sirens as soon as we got the call. We got here.
El padre pasó de quejarse de la violencia física al consumo de drogas y payasadas de su hijo y cambiar por completo sus drogas y su historia. Fue bueno que no quisiera que arrestaran a su hijo, pero probablemente debería haber pensado en esto antes de llamar a la policía. Desafortunadamente, el hijo no aprovechó esta oportunidad gratuita que se le dio.
No, he was out there in his truck.
Okay, well, he was out in the truck, and you went out there, and he was passed out, right?
Look, officer, may I get what I took off of his lap out of the trash for you?
We'll get there.
Would you like to see it?
We'll get there in one second.
Aluminum foil, big old burn mark in it, and he's laying there like this. All right, walked up there and smacked him on his chest about 10 times.
Did he, like, make you leave, or?
Well, I was looking for my wallet, and next thing you know, I walk outside because he said something about it being in my truck. So I walk back out there. Next thing I know, I'm coming up here, and all the doors are locked. I get mail in here. So no doors should ever be locked for me.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it just got on my head. A couple times where I smacked the door.
I want my son off the dope.
I can understand
hard,
that.
Hard for him. I want my son off the dope. I want him to get custody of his own kid and control his own life.
It's hard for
What's
him.
What's so hard about
it's
that,
It's hard
man?
For him. Well, I can guarantee you that.
I try to be there every step of the way.
I know. I'm not defending him.
And he works for me, and I feel like when I give him money, I
are helping enable him.
Exactly.
I understand
I get that.
I get that.
It seems like when I give him money, he runs off and gone for a few hours, and then he comes back and he's sitting in his truck being doing stupid.
Well,
I don't
you shouldn't feel that way. I get why you do, but you know, if you don't give him the money, he's going to get it somewhere else, whether it be from
somebody else or whatever. I get it. I get it.
And he's a big boy.
Yeah.
I mean, unfortunately, he's making his own stupid decisions. And at some point, I know this is going to suck to hear.
I know my son, and he's very immature.
Sometimes you got to cut that cord.
Well, I'm not sure exactly what's going to happen. Obviously, I got to talk to my partner, but what would you like done?
I just want him to go to his house in Jackson soon.
You just want him to leave?
Arrested. I don't want him to go to jail.
Well, I can't guarantee you anything, but I got to obviously talk to the other.
I want him to get help.
Well, I understand that.
I want him to get help.
The problem is, in the state of Ohio...
Well,
that's fair.
That's but, my opinion.
But this is a state we live in, so we have to go by
the
law.
That's the state that I wear on my shoulders. So what I'm saying is that in the state of Ohio, when there's a domestic situation with injuries, which clearly there are, 9 times out of 10, he's going to jail because we actually press those charges.
Well, we have to act. We have to act because
I was chasing through the yard and I fell and busted my glasses. That's what happened.
El padre se apresuró a levantarse y lavar la evidencia de la cara y después de reunirse, la policía decidió dejar que el hombre se fuera sin más consecuencias. A pesar de sus buenos modales, el hombre estaba cada vez más agitado. Aquí fue donde las cosas comenzaron a empeorar drásticamente.
Hold on one second. We might want to get pictures. I'm not sure.
Are you sitting there?
I'm just...
I want to go wash my face.
Well, let me ask a...
But it's kind of aggravating that we got him out of the situation, so he didn't have to look at some of the stuff, and then it's just brought to our hands. Yeah, you want to be there. You can only do so much.
What's he doing?
He was trying to wash his face.
Uh-oh. Did he say what he wanted? Did he want charges or anything or what?
So, at first I asked him, he told me a story about hitting him and everything else. So then we said, well, because of domestic violence, we have a right, even at the victim. So he said, oh no, I fell and landed on my face and busted my glasses. So he never hit me. He's like, he don't want his son to go to jail. He's like, his son never hit him. That's his story. He's
okay.
Like, I fell and my glasses broke, which caused the damage to his face.
Okay. Okay.
He says he doesn't like us, he hates cops, and the only reason why we're here is because she called.
Does he have a cell phone in here?
Yeah, he says he does, but I don't know. All the rest of around, look, I look, you can look, you're more than welcome to look.
Is there somebody that could come pick him up? Or how about a neighbor? Just so you guys know somebody.
His girlfriend might be able to come and pick him up.
Where does she live?
Her parents, St. Paris, 40 minutes away.
Well, we can't stay here 40 minutes, wait for somebody to pick him up.
El hombre estaba siendo increíblemente grosero y arrogante con los oficiales y esto iba a hacer que su decisión fuera mucho más fácil. Después de evitar la pelea que casi estalló en la cara y llevarlo afuera, los oficiales lamentablemente descubrirían que estaba lejos de terminar sus peleas y payasadas salvajes.
Tried leaving 3 different times, but nobody wants to give me my wallet. Nobody wants to give me my cell phone.
Let's hang, bro. Let's maybe not start another fight in here, because I'm honestly not gonna...
I'm not in the mood either. I want my
Oh, that's wife's phone.
Woke up and in self-defense.
You're going to go to jail. We're trying to help you out. So just stop.
Like I said, you guys have no reason. You guys have no reason to hold me.
These marks was done first.
We don't have a reason. Well, we've actually told you to calm down, and you haven't. That's now disorderly conduct.
But do you not understand what I'm under emotionally? I don't think you understand,
because I've told you three times.
Let me clear this up. My grandmother passed out.
Yeah, I've heard this now five times.
And you don't give a bit of sympathy for somebody that's going through quite a bit.
Why do you think we're letting you leave instead of going to jail? That is sympathy.
Dawson, just calm down.
No, I want my motherfucking phone.
I thought we found
it. You have your phone. It's in your phone.
Okay, don't get shitty with me because I've got my mind right now.
We are literally...
What's he looking for? His wallet?
Yeah, his wallet.
I think he left that in his buddy's red...
Hyundai.
Is that possible? You
when they went to get the dope.
Well, I'm trying, dude, but my phone just died.
He mentioned his mom or his wife. Are we okay with that if she gives him a ride?
I don't care.
They got along with that. I'll at least ask.
Take away from your mom.
I don't want nothing to do with either one of them.
Man, we are trying. We've gone so much further.
It's going to be pretty much.
Then I guess I'm just going to have to get arrested.
He is coming to get you. Chill the fuck.
Where's she coming from?
Aunque alguien estaba de camino a recogerlo, el hombre simplemente presionó demasiado su suerte. Los policías ya habían tenido lo suficiente y lo esposaron. Estaba siendo tan exasperante que uno de los oficiales le dio una de las reprimendas más fuertes posibles. ¿Pero creen que este encuentro lo habría asustado?
All you had to do was shut your mouth.
It's hard, dude.
I don't care. I have asked you 20 times.
Well, obviously you don't understand how.
Stop!
Really gonna spin me in my f***ing ground like
you
that?
You tried to spin, man. Would you quit? Please!
We're trying to be kind to you.
Stop!
Quit pushing my f***ing face on the hood.
I'm not going nowhere.
Oh man, we tried so freaking hard with you.
El hijo fue acusado de violencia doméstica, agresión y alteración del orden público. Nuestra siguiente disputa familiar, por otro lado, fue bastante más dramática y más difícil de contener. Abofeteó a su madre. El 5 de febrero de 2023, una mujer llamó a los oficiales de policía de Des Moines después de que su hijo drogadicto entrara en su casa. Hubo un altercado físico en el que la madre recibió un golpe en la cabeza y después de eso su hijo huyó. Más tarde esa noche regresó a la casa y llamaron a la policía una vez más. Lo que sigue a continuación es la escena intensa y caótica que se produjo cuando el joven fue detenido en la casa de su madre. Los agentes entraron y encontraron al joven cómodamente descansando en el sofá. Al principio obedeció a los agentes, pero se podía oler su actitud a una milla de distancia. Estaba cada vez más en apuros durante su registro obligatorio y aunque pidió salir a fumar no llegaron tan lejos gracias únicamente a sus propias payasadas.
Hello.
2118.
Who's he at?
110. 110.
What the fuck? I called.
Can I come in?
Huh?
How you doing?
I'm good. Are you good?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right.
You wanna come outside and talk to me?
About?
Some stuff that happened earlier today?
Nothing happened earlier today.
301.
Are you gonna arrest me? That's what I'm asking. Are you arresting me?
301. Yeah, 319, come inside.
Are you arresting me?
Yes.
For what?
For assault.
For assault?
Yep. Let's just make this easy.
I didn't assault nobody.
Okay, let's just make this. Let's make it easy.
We're gonna make it easy. I'm gonna put my stuff in my backpack.
Okay.
If you pull your gun out, I'm going to.
I'm not gonna pull a gun. Look. I need to pat you.
You're not patting me down.
Look.
Don't touch me.
Stop.
You just said we're gonna go outside.
Okay.
I'm not.
Okay. But I gotta pat you down because I don't know what.
Okay. You're gonna pat me down outside. I don't want none of my stuff left here.
Okay. That's fine.
Let me pat you down.
Let me pat you down for weapons. Okay. Do you have any weapons?
If I had a weapon, you'd be dead.
Okay.
And that's on my dead brother.
Okay.
I don't have no weapon, sir.
All right.
Grab my headphones for me,
okay.
Please.
Yep.
Can I smoke a cigarette before
we're,
I go to jail?
We're going outside.
All right. Can I smoke a cigarette? My cigarette's on the couch.
All right. We'll get it all the way. Just work with us. I'll work with you.
Go get my cigarette, Dakota.
Okay.
You're a bitch and you're dead to me, you lying.
El chico quedó inmovilizado muy rápidamente cuando empezó a pelear con los agentes, pero es gracioso lo rápido que pasó de ser un tipo duro a llorar y gritar porque estaba herido. Se puso en actitud de víctima muy rápidamente y para empeorar las cosas, la madre también empezó a gritar e interferir.
My toe is broken.
It'll be easier.
My toe is broken.
Did you, sir?
Bro, my toe is broken and you're squeezing it. I can't relax. No, I sue all you bitches. On my dead homie. You
walking up around the side.
Hey, you.
Please.
Go eat a cat. You.
We're good. Any other units know that we're in the back, coming the back door.
Stop it, you dummy!
You.
I will fucking kill you!
Bam! Bam! Bam!
You!
Go upstairs!
You're my kids!
You!
Ma'am,
Mom, go upstairs!
Shut up, you
go upstairs, because you're about to see something you don't want to see.
No, I'm not, because
you're about to see a cop die.
Ma'am,
you're about to see a cop die. You stupid fucking pig. Swine.
Cuando finalmente lo detuvieron y lo sacaron de la casa, el niño comenzó a escupir a varios oficiales. El siguiente paso fue ponerle una máscara anti-escupitajos, pero no dejaba de discutir, gritar y hacer amenazas incluso mientras lo subían al coche de policía. Como si las cosas no fueran lo suficientemente difíciles, la madre también apareció para intentar causar otra ronda de problemas, pero el oficial la calmó rápidamente.
Bro, I'm not walking out this house without my shoes.
Hey!
I'm not gonna spit on you again, nigga. If you choke me up, my hoodie. 21.
I come here the other day to save you from overdose on heroin. You're gonna spit in my face? That's how it's gonna be? You need to go home, please.
Okay, this is my son. I'm just saying, okay. I just want to make sure the officer's okay.
He's going to the hospital, so.
Okay, well, so why are you being a to me, dude? I'm just asking to see if he's okay.
Because you.
Listen to me. If you guys would have done something about this a week ago when I started calling and asking for the help, this wouldn't have
happened. Have a good night,
ma'am. Are you serious?
Debido a la naturaleza violenta de este sospechoso, necesitaba ser transportado a la camioneta de policía. Seguro que se hizo el ridículo, pero aún así sostuvo que era más rico y mejor que los oficiales. ¿Crees que el niño necesita una revisión seria de la realidad o ya ha llegado demasiado lejos en este camino?
Kale, we're gonna give you your shoe. We're gonna put your shoe on, okay? We've got to pat you down again,
Kale. My phone and call Shane.
We've got to pat you down again.
My phone is in your house. They took everything in my pocket.
We're going to lose these cuffs on.
Yep. We're just going to take this other one off.
Who is you?
Kale, don't pay attention to him.
It's funny, huh?
Kale.
Don't pay attention to him, okay?
These cops are... I know. Okay. Appreciate it.
Spread your legs. I got to pat you down.
Bro, I've been patted down 7 times.
It's policy and procedure, okay?
Fuck your policy and procedure. You also...
Los agentes fueron a visitar a la madre esa mañana, después de que se produjera la pelea inicial. Y esas son las imágenes que estamos viendo ahora. Los agentes habían conocido al chico y habían tratado con él en muchas ocasiones. Incluso había estado en la cárcel antes. La madre estaba mucho más tranquila en esta ocasión y pudo pintar una imagen perfectamente clara de lo que sucedió.
Did he go south or north? Okay.
He was doing drugs in my bathroom. I asked him to leave. And then he just came up to me and went all nuts. And like, he said, give me your keys, bitch. He was going to take my car. So I went to grab my purse and he grabbed my purse from me. So I put my hands on it because I was trying to get my purse.
Right.
And he smacked the shit out of me on my forehead. It friggin' burns. And then he smacked him.
Are you brother?
We were over here the other day.
No, and he keeps coming back, and I can't get him to not. And he kicked in my back door, so my house is even secure. And
does he live here? He's been living here, though.
No.
Where does he live?
On the streets, in a trap house. I can't keep doing this. He just popped up last night, and my sister had just gotten here to pick up my
Did you call us last night?
And he came in last night, and I couldn't get him out of here. What's the point? Because every time I call you guys, you can't do nothing to get him out. He just comes right back.
Does he have clothes and stuff in there?
No. He has nothing here.
Okay. 323.
What was he doing the other day when we were out here? Because he was here. He overdosed and we were out here.
With the cousin.
I wasn't here.
No.
All I know is he supposedly...
left you a nice pile of puke in your living room.
Yeah, that was funny.
323.
325.
I just broke my nail. Sorry.
He was with the cousin or something.
Supposedly he took some sort of pill. He said he's going to take all her money out of her bank account. He's going to burn her garage down. Has her social. He has my dad's social. My dad's passed away in June.
El hombre recibió una serie de cargos que incluían agresión con daños corporales y enfermedad mental, agresión a un agente de la policía por 3, posesión de una sustancia controlada y violencia de una sustancia controlada. También fue acusado de desacato, acoso y violación de una orden de no contacto y fuga de custodia en primer grado. Nuestra siguiente sospechosa también violó una orden de no contacto, pero parecía mucho más desquiciada al final de la investigación. Thompson Kenna Cherith. El 1 de julio de 2022, un anciano y su esposa llamaron a la policía a una residencia local. La hija de la pareja estaba frente a una casa gritando y haciendo una escena e incumpliendo inadvertidamente los términos de su orden de no contacto. Cuando llegaron los oficiales, el hombre se acercó a esta puerta y le explicó la desastrosa situación a la que se enfrentaba con su hijastra. Veamos qué sucedió a continuación.
¿Did you call?
Yes, sir.
What's going on?
I'm a stepdaughter. There's no contact with it. Yes. And she came this way. She came this way. And she's got a street officer, some weird stuff. I think I even had a lot of people. So, just, I was always going by, and she just didn't have a spell.
She had no contact.
Okay, so she has a, as part of her conditions of release. Okay. So it's not a restraining order. And what's she wearing?
White shirt. White shorts.
White shorts?
I think it was brown
top. Okay.
She's got the short.
Los padres le proporcionaron a los oficiales la documentación necesaria que demostraba que ella estaba incumpliendo una orden legal de no contacto y, para ser honestos, ya parecía bastante agotado por toda la situación. Momentos después, los oficiales ven a la mujer caminando por la calle. Inmediatamente trató de evitarlos y alejarse de ellos, mostrándonos exactamente cómo iba a ser el resto del encuentro.
Becky, have your ID on you, sir?
Yes.
So was she standing in the roadway or was she on your property?
She was standing. No, she wasn't in. Okay, she was just out there by was she up against the fence? Just between the paint and the fence. Stand up there.
What was she screaming? Could you tell?
Hey, Miss Thompson, come here. Come here. Come here. Hey, Miss Thompson, come here. If I gotta chase you down, you are going to jail. Get over here.
My name is Kenna Sharif Thompson. I'm not allowed there.
I know you're not allowed there. That's why I'm calling to talk to you.
That's why I walk around here. I made friends with them guys. Go ask them. I'm walking.
You're walking in the middle of the road yelling at cars.
Yelling at cars? I'm talking to that man.
To what man?
I'm talking to my friend. I can only talk to my friends because y'all arrest me. These are my cigarettes. This is my lighter. I have no dope on me. I do take Adderall. It's at my mom's. I have to leave it there to keep it safe. That's the only time I go there is to take medicine. Otherwise, I circle this neighborhood everywhere.
Okay.
And I have a couple places I can stop and drink water.
So I've got two calls on you today.
Okay, well, there's two places they don't need to go.
I've got two calls on you today.
Mr. Powers.
Okay.
Well, if you don't know Mr. Powers, I do.
Who's Mr. Powers?
Mr. Powers lives over there in the corner.
Okay, you so what are you doing over here?
Because they make me be over here.
Who?
My parents, the Beavers. 2013 State Street. I have a no-contact order. Reverse it. He got up. I don't want to do this to my dad. Go ask him if I can borrow his truck. I have to keep on walking.
Okay, so yeah, you have a no-contact order. So you're not supposed to be over there.
Go ask him. I don't go over there.
Hey, stay right here. Kina.
Era claramente una bala perdida y cuando intentó escapar de los policías después de haber sido advertida, la única opción era esposarla. Por supuesto, esto hizo que ella comenzara a gritar y a perder los estribos, pero los oficiales finalmente lograron subirla a la parte trasera del coche de policía. Sin embargo, lamentablemente el viaje a la cárcel no sería nada tranquilo.
If you don't stop, you're gonna go to jail.
Ask him. Go ask that man.
Put your hands behind your back.
No, they're gonna take me to jail.
Stop.
Please.
Stop.
You are. No.
Stop. Put your hands.
You are. I didn't go there.
Stop.
I have to go there when Bob's not there. You're violating my state rights. I already got. You want my number for state ID? It has the bruises all over it to prove it. I don't have one. You just did that to me? Now my brother's screwed. Now we don't get nothing, guys. Thanks a lot. Told you! Mexico, help me! Officers! Popos! Arrested! Arrested! At the Sanchez house! Arrested!
Miss Thompson's 1015, REO.
Ryan Sosa. I wasn't yelling
at you. Alright, come on. We're going to the car.
Alright. Make sure somebody picks up my cigarettes, please. That's where I was walking around, is Ryan Sosa's. And his son already left.
All right. Step up in there and have a seat, okay?
I can
do that. You got anything else in your pocket?
No, I don't have nothing. You can feel what it is. I don't know what it is.
I don't know what it is either.
Oh, they're eating some trash. I don't have nothing, Jesus. I promise. No, my bra. You want me to check my own bra? I will. You can have Ryan check my bra.
All right. Have a seat up in there.
Okay.
La mujer despotricó sobre cualquier cosa y dijo tantas tonterías que nadie podía seguir lo que decía, aunque quisiera. Después de un viaje increíblemente largo a la cárcel en que la mujer no paró de hablar ni un segundo, los oficiales finalmente llegaron a la estación de policía. Desafortunadamente esto no iría mucho mejor, y el hecho de que la mujer no se resistiera físicamente era lo único que lo beneficiaba. ¿Creen que sus desvaríos absolutamente incoherentes se debían a que estaba intoxicada?
Yeah, you can take me there so I can be in peace, kicking it there with her, because she kicks it in peace, but I have to have weed, and y'all said I can't have none. So, her spirit's bumping up, and she's getting tired of Brandy being there. She's not. She pays her $20 every day to be there to take care of her. That's her daughter-in-law. I don't get paid nothing. I don't even get paid $20 a week. She gets it $20 a day. I don't get paid nothing. I have a zero job. No job. Homeless. She got a car. My mom got a car. I seen it. My sister looked cool in it. It looked like my mom got a brand new Mustang. Where's my one bad aunt car? Because that was my car. Who parked it? Yeah.
I can't get a ride without Michael Wright getting rides.
Go ahead and step out.
Okay. Send me this out. Lunch out the door, Lorianus or Epi Vasquez.
Watch your step.
Will not forgive nobody.
Watch out. Step over the side. There you go. Go ahead and walk forward. Keep going, keep going, keep going. And step right over there by that window for me.
Okay. Okay, Sharif Thompson. My daughter did the ancestry. She knows more of my inheritance. I don't know if I'm, I think I'm German, white, and somebody else can have a drink of water.
Mm-hmm.
I have Adderall. You can give me a drug test.
There's water in there.
Who
Well, I passed my drug test yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah.
Good job.
I passed the shell shot. I passed it again today. I took an Adderall. Bring the can out here. I need a drink of cold water, really.
They'll get you a drink of water once we get inside.
You're going to take me to jail. You're going to take me to jail. This is not peaceful.
This is jail.
I'm not in jail.
You are in jail.
You're not going to call those numbers for me.
No, you're going to call them once we get over to the phone.
They won't answer from the jail.
Oh.
Because they think I'm screwing up. They think I'm out here being a tweaker. I'm not. I'm on vacation. I passed my test. Call the sheriff.
Oh, the sheriff knows about it?
Sheriff Valenzuela.
Who's Sheriff Valenzuela?
It is my sheriff of any county, right?
No.
Michelle Schott is my probation officer.
Okay.
So go ask her.
Fue acusada de resistirse, evadir y obstruir a un oficial. El siguiente sospechoso que estaremos analizando tuvo un colapso de salud mental más grave, pero alcanzó un nivel tan intenso que su madre sintió la necesidad de llamar a la policía una vez más. Laura. La policía de Miami, Florida, respondió a una situación doméstica muy delicada el 10 de diciembre de 2023. La madre denunció una agresión doméstica y su hija estaba sufriendo un grave episodio mental, por lo que los agentes ya sabían que la situación sería difícil de solucionar. Cuando llegaron a la escena, los agentes ya podían oír fuertes gritos procedentes de la residencia, así que estén atentos para ver qué sucedió a continuación.
What is your name?
Laura.
Laura, come talk to me, Laura. So, your mom will be taken care of over here. What's going on, Laura? Why do I smell so much bleach?
Because I spilled the bleach on me.
I see it.
Yeah, I spilled the bleach and my sister has told her to stop getting the police on the phone.
Mientras el agente entrevistaba a la mujer en cuestión, nos enteramos de algunas cosas interesantes, como que ya tenía un caso pendiente por delito grave en su contra. Había mucha animosidad entre la mujer y su madre, provocando que la hija se pusiera bastante emotiva. Era sospechoso que ella también siguiera evitando la cuestión de la aflejía y no actuaba como una adulta para una mujer de 31 años.
What were you doing with the bleach?
I was in the bathroom. My mom was already on the phone. The cops, I said, stop, and I spilled the bleach. And
okay, but you didn't tell me. What were you doing with the bleach?
Okay, so first of all, it started because I was trying to rekindle my friendship with my boyfriend, and everybody keeps saying that he's got somebody else. I'm like, why does everybody keep saying that? And my mom said, it's my fault. I ruined everything.
What?
And my sister told her to stop getting the cops on the phone. I've been through hospitals after hospitals.
Laura, police is not a bad thing.
No, but I have a case already going on.
What type of case?
A felony case, because I got accused of something back in March, and I told my
that,
apparently cutting somebody with a knife.
Okay.
I had to do not here, somewhere else. And I have a lawyer, and my lawyer told my mom to stop getting hospitals on the phone. Let Laura calm down.
No, she didn't.
She told me to back off!
Laura, you're gonna talk quietly.
Quedó claro que la hija había amenazado de muerte a su exnovio y había rociado a su madre con lejía. A pesar de todo, la madre solicitó un equipo de salud mental y parecía querer realmente que su hija recibiera ayuda. Desafortunadamente, ella ya había admitido que la joven había cometido la agresión y cada vez se ponía más nerviosa.
And you know how the process is with the healthcare system. She's going to go in and out in the hospital.
I'm under the impression that Miami-Dade has a better mental health system.
Yeah, but that's
going to
be aftercare.
Okay.
But what we got going on today, that you hid in the bathroom and you were scared and she came after you.
But she had already been throwing things and breaking things. And I was trying to call you also. I went into the bathroom to continue the call.
Yep.
When did she pull your hair?
About 10 minutes ago, right as you were showing up here. I was in the kitchen, she threw my phone, she grabbed me, pulled my hair, okay? Tried to throw me off balance. I just had a stroke in September. My balance isn't that great to begin with, you know. But in any event...
And you were trying to help her in this whole time too?
Yeah, I pulled her off.
You pulled her off. Okay.
But as I said, when she has proper help and they have the facts, then she can do much better. She also has ADD, which is an impulse control problem to begin with. Okay? And she can be very smart, very diligent. She was a licensed security guard.
Okay?
And right now, she has been asked to have a background check because they probably found out that she has some criminal charges now for reacting badly to bullies.
What her name is?
She misinterprets what people tell her.
Yes.
She is paranoid. She's making threats.
What is her diagnosis?
I don't know the diagnosis? Current. I don't know the current. And here's what I need to tell you.
Okay.
She started out.
I'm writing down everything. I'm not ignoring you.
I didn't think you were. I really didn't. She's misleading the officer right now.
Cuando los oficiales se dispusieron a detener a Laura, ella perdió completamente la calma. En lugar de obedecer y ponérselo fácil, Laura optó por quejarse, gritar y llorar tanto como pudo, provocando una escena dramática. La policía se dispuso a escoltarla fuera de la situación y dentro del coche de policía, ya que claramente no se iba a calmar. ¿Crees que había algo que pudiera haberla calmado?
Listen, I didn't do anything. Step by step, everything. She's gonna talk to the state attorney's office. No. She's gonna talk to all the lawyers in the court.
Are you okay trying to help her put it on?
Yeah.
No, I'm not doing anything.
Put the shorts first.
Okay.
She's gonna talk to the state attorney's office, okay?
However, we have no discretion, you know, like your mom.
But I'm not doing anything.
This is your mom and your mom's age. Laura.
No, but I'm not, I didn't do anything.
You're gonna put your feet in?
Natalie, why did you open the door? I didn't do anything. You're making me go to jail.
Okay, we're gonna put in a car. Maybe we can put in.
Is she going to jail?
Había estado gritando y discutiendo todo el tiempo. Todavía intentaba afirmar que era inocente y que no hizo nada. Siguió razonando con los oficiales sin sentido durante un tiempo que pareció una eternidad. Pero finalmente se trasladó voluntariamente al coche.
I don't understand, I'm not doing anything. She's trying to make my life worse. What is she doing?
Okay.
But you're taking me to jail.
Yes, ma'am, we have to. Look, whatever is domestic, we have to.
I didn't do anything. She's the one who, she punched me in the head.
Yeah.
I didn't do anything. You're ruining my life. No, but Natalie, why is she?
Todavía no está claro de qué fue acusada la mujer, pero nuestro siguiente sospechoso logró acumular una larga lista que eran completamente evitables. Michael Brown. Por lo general, las disputas se dan entre padres e hijos adultos más jóvenes, pero algunas personas nunca superan la fase, como en el caso de nuestro siguiente sospechoso, Michael Brown. El departamento del sheriff del condado de Lake respondió a una llamada doméstica angustiante de una señora muy mayor y su hijo, que ya era bastante mayor de edad. Los oficiales actuaron rápidamente y aunque las cosas estaban tranquilas cuando llegaron, esto no duraría demasiado. Los oficiales encontraron al hombre y a su perro afuera y por supuesto él afirmó que no había pasado nada. Inmediatamente notamos que parecía bastante ebrio y esto ya hizo notar las alarmas silenciosas. Los oficiales fueron razonables, pero no pasó mucho tiempo antes de que el hombre comenzara a insultarlos. Desafortunadamente, su comportamiento grosero y beligerante solo iba a intensificarse.
Hey, homie. This is Sammy.
Sammy.
Hello, Sammy.
That's a big dog.
Hey, little boy. Jack. Pepper.
So, Mike.
What?
Let's try and work something out tonight to get you and your mom separated just until tomorrow that thing's cooled down.
I didn't do anything since the last time you left. I've done absolutely nothing.
I know. I know,
okay.
But from what your mom is telling me, like I said, that she said as soon as I left, against my wishes, what you and I shook on, she said that you kept going at her, verbally.
Oh, you know what? That's a lie. She's a liar.
So what I'm asking you is to help yourself out, help us out.
No.
And I could take you somewhere, I'd be happy to do that.
That's totally idiotic. I didn't do any of that, and...
Looks like we're in. I'll be with Philadelphia passenger Z049-1012.
I wanted her to leave me alone. Okay. She won't leave me alone.
So, did you go down to your room? Because I highly doubt that she came downstairs.
Do what?
Did you go downstairs to your room like we discussed?
Idiot?
Yeah. Yes, you were.
Okay.
Because you don't know nothing and you've got your yappy little mouth coming out.
I've been here for 5 minutes and I can already tell you the problem.
Oh, are you?
How old's your mom?
You're an expert.
How old's your mother?
Really?
How old's your mother?
Oh.
You're grown, aren't you?
I am leaving, actually.
Yeah, good job.
Are you fucking...
Good job.
What the f*** are you?
Good job.
What the f*** are you? You probably live in your mom's... basement.
I guarantee you I'm not. Guarantee you I'm not.
No, you. See, look at this. See, you got a fucking you here talking to me, and you got a that thinks he's bad. You bad.
Cuando más se suponía el hombre, el oficial, más claro se hacía que estaba bastante borracho. Como si mostrar su barriga cervecera ante las cámaras de los oficiales no fuera lo suficientemente vergonzoso. Estaba a punto de causar una gran escena. Los oficiales estaban listos para actuar, solo necesitaba salir de la casa.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't even know what you're saying.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Should
probably stop drinking as much. Help your mom out. Help your mom out.
Maybe you should f***ing know your own f***ing business.
Help your mom
and out. Stay out of the f*** out of mine. I've helped my mom out for over 7 f***ing years, you f***ing idiot.
Okay.
What?
Well, what are you doing now?
Shut
up. You're not helping her.
Up.
You're not helping her now.
You're a f***ing idiot.
Okay.
Do you know what a f***ing idiot is?
No. What is one?
You.
Okay.
You're a fucking idiot that thinks they can pull up on a fucking private place.
Sounds like you got one there.
Fuck you.
Okay.
You know what? There you go, Mom. Look at this stupid mother. You got out here.
Hi, ma'am.
Hi. Yeah. Look at that.
We're just gonna ask for some.
Look at that. Okay. He's a professional.
We're gonna ask for some privacy here for a moment.
We'll do what?
I'm asking for a little privacy here for a moment.
Man, that ain't happening.
G971-1 added.
Stop.
Before you make the Stop. Dude, stop.
Oh, honey, you're talking.
Stop.
Now.
Stop.
Just stop.
Outside.
No, my God. You know what? Get the f*** out of here.
Listen, I'm going to put you in handcuffs.
Who let you in here?
Hey,
I'm here for a legal
Mike,
for
I'm going to put you
person.
This.
Stop.
I'm going to put you in handcuffs.
You ain't f***ing putting me in
Stop.
Shit. Stop, dude.
Stop.
Relax.
You f***.
Take it
outside. Outside.
Ratchet.
Outside.
Come on, let's go outside.
Outside. Let's go.
What is it, Mike? Come on.
Mike, come on, Mike.
El intento del hombre de correr y resistirse fue bastante infructuoso y terminó rápidamente inmovilizado contra el pasto. Sin embargo, claramente no se dio cuenta de que la pelea había terminado, ya que siguió rodando y tratando de patear a los oficiales. En lugar de simplemente obedecer, este hombre recibió una acusación por delito grave.
Behind your back. Come on.
Behind your back, Mike. Yeah. Yeah. Sure. Actually.
Actually,
Mike, you worthless. Just
stop.
You
stop, Mike.
No.
Stop.
No! Oh. You. Motherfucker! Are y'all good now? Are y'all good now? From an old bitch that shit dementia. Yeah. Yeah.
Listen.
You want to shoot me?
I'm not gonna shoot you.
Nah.
Ni siquiera un equipo completo de oficiales pudo mantener a raya a este hombre, y sus diatribas y amenazas continuaron. Estaba siendo lo más dramático y poco cooperativo posible, y los paramédicos pronto llegarían. ¿Pueden adivinar si les haría las cosas más fáciles?
I want them to check you all out, you fucking brain dead motherfuckers.
Well, I don't need them.
Well, yeah. I think
I'm
you do.
I'm trying to find out what you need them for.
No, I think you do. Motherfucker. I am gonna have you fucking sued.
Stop kicking.
Well, kicking at us ain't gonna make a cause for you.
Oh, go f***
yourself. You're gonna end up with more charges.
I don't give a f***. Charges for what?
We'll see.
You assaulting me?
Are you gonna be nice?
You assaulting me?
Hey, sir, you called an ambulance?
Yep, so I did.
For what? What hurts you?
Because they assaulted and abused me.
You gotta work with us, though, all right?
Nah.
Roll over on your butt, and then we're gonna push you forward, okay?
Nah, you're the mother stupid mother that handcuffed me.
Okay, are you gonna
stand
up?
I ain't listening to nothing you say.
Well, you can't go to the hospital if you can't get up.
Sir, what's your name?
Yeah, Bummer.
What is it?
And I guess you gotta sue them, too.
What's your name?
Because they're gonna sue you. I'm gonna sue them. Out of you. I didn't do anything.
I'm just a paramedic.
Nah. Well, there you go. Here we are.
I sure
I didn't do anything. And I'm handcuffed, subdued.
You guys got leg restraints?
Yeah.
Alright. Alright, we want to go.
There you go.
Yeah. Stand up. Right. Roll over this way, boss. There you go. There
you go. Yo,
push
you
forward. Wait,
tuck
your foot in.
Nah,
tuck
you're
push sucker. It up, you're gonna stand up,
push
okay?
Yeah.
Here, do you
want to
grab this side?
Yep. Nah, you fucking suckers.
There you go, boss.
Fuck you.
We're gonna sit you right on this cot over here, yeah?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Actually, no.
You don't want to go to the hospital now? You said you wanted to go, boss. You tell us.
My pants are falling down. These motherfuckers.
No.
That's prick in particular.
Right. You want to go to the hospital or not, boss?
Yes.
Alright, they got to put you on this thing.
You remember me, you sucking motherfucker.
We got to back you up a little bit.
I'll see you.
Go backwards.
I will see you. I will see you. You fucking.
Hey, you don't need to talk like that, okay?
No. Yourself.
You knock it off.
You. Okay.
Michael fue acusado de agresión a un oficial de policía, obstrucción a un agente de la paz y resistirse al arresto. Aunque claramente había algo de mala sangre entre él y su madre, nada se compara con nuestra siguiente investigación, donde estalló un altercado físico entre un padre y su hijo, nada menos que por un control remoto de televisión. Pelea por el control remoto de la televisión. Pasando de la infame pelea por el control remoto de televisión, fue el 20 de abril de 2023 cuando la policía respondió a otro disturbio local. Un padre llamó al 911 porque había tenido un altercado físico con su hijo. Según el relato del hombre, se desató una pelea violenta y su hijo incluso amenazó con apuñalarlo con un destornillador. Cuando llegó la policía, el hijo ya se había ido del lugar, pero el padre estaba visiblemente golpeado y ensangrentado.
Hi, sir. Are you doing okay?
Yeah.
Okay. We have fire rescue on the way, okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Okay, well, they're just here. I'm not saying you don't have to go to the hospital or anything, but they're just making sure that you're okay, all right? Is there anyone else in the house?
My roommate, he's sleeping in the bedroom.
Okay. So what, he got you with a screwdriver or
well,
something?
Well, he attacked me with a screwdriver and he beat me on the face. You know,
with the screwdriver or with his hand or
no,
something?
No, he had a screwdriver in his hand. He didn't stab me with it.
No, did he? Yeah, but how did he get the gash on your hand?
He punched me.
Punching you with the screwdriver, with the screwdriver or with his hand? Or with the butt end of the screwdriver?
I think just with his hand. He had a screwdriver in the other hand.
Okay, but he didn't
stick me with that, but he kept coming at me with it.
What do you mean, coming at you?
He's got mental issues.
Okay, well, what do you mean, coming at you? Like, was he, like, making motions or what?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, gotcha.
That's why I had to put my arms up and block him. We started wrestling around him, he got on top and he started punching me in the head and everything.
Is the screwdriver still here?
I don't know.
Did he take it with him, or do you know?
I have no idea. I was trying to get the license plate, and then he kicked me in the side and in the back when I tried to get the license plate.
Okay.
Because this isn't the first time he's done this to me. You guys have police reports on it, too.
Has he been drinking tonight?
Probably, yeah, a little. Yeah, he has.
Yeah, he's got a decent laceration in his right eye.
And this happened before, and I refused to press charges, and I should have went through with it, but I didn't. This happened about 5 or 6 months ago, maybe.
Okay.
When he did it to
me. So how did this all start?
Over a TV remote that he took, because he just...
Did he used to live here?
Got a mental problem. He lives here.
Okay. Was he taking it somewhere else, or...
I don't know, and he just went nuts.
Okay. Man, but you're for sure certain he had the what hand did he have the screwdriver in? You know, his right hand?
Yeah.
Okay. Right.
He hit, I don't know, you know, it's happened so fast.
Okay.
It's my son, you know?
Right, I understand. But he had it in his right hand?
He just held the screwdriver.
Okay. But
remember.
You said he came at you with the screwdriver. Like he was advancing towards you with the.
Yeah.
Okay. Were you afraid that he was going to stab you with the screwdriver?
Well, yeah, that's why I had to try to do something. You know, I didn't know if he was going to stab me with it or not.
But then
when I was trying to hold his arm, and he just kept punching me in the side of the head.
Gotcha.
El padre explicó exactamente lo que sucedió a los oficiales y aunque la historia de su hijo no cuadraba, él era el único con las cicatrices. Aparentemente el hijo había pateado al hombre y lo había golpeado en la cabeza y esta no era la primera vez que las cosas se ponían físicas. Los servicios médicos de urgencia estaban en camino y en unos momentos el hijo también llegaría a la escena.
Okay, and then I tried to get away from him.
And then he started hitting you some
more. As soon as my back was turned, I ran from the kitchen in here. I'm going, Brian, you got to stop and tackle me in here. Then we got back up, but he hit me in here, and that's when he had the screwdriver. And I grabbed his hand.
He said you threw some plates. Did you throw a plate at him?
Yeah, because I tried to hit him with something because he kept coming at me.
Was that before or after he said
that? Was after he busted me in the head.
So he hit you first?
Yeah. I was trying to protect myself.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm alright, how you doing?
So what's going on, man?
My dad just got into it with me. He's drunk. Started hitting me and shit. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to leave, man, because he's hitting me and blaming shit on me.
Okay. You been drinking too tonight?
No.
Okay, alright. Well, if I have you just step out real quick, you don't have any weapons on you, do you?
No, I ain't got nothing, man.
Okay. Alright.
I was just trying
face this way. I just want to search you real quick. Face this way. Just make sure.
Yeah,
put
fine.
Hands behind your back. Alright. So, just want to make sure you don't have any weapons. And I want to get your side of the story. And I want to get that side.
El hijo estaba bastante tranquilo y comunicativo y esto no era exactamente lo que esperaban los policías. Afirmó estar sobrio, pero el policía tenía sospechas de que no estaba siendo completamente sincero. Luego aceptó una prueba de sobriedad en el campo para averiguarlo. ¿Cómo creen que terminará esto?
My father started accusing me of his TV, okay?
Okay.
I tried helping him with it.
What's wrong with the TV, real quick?
It's password, Amazon, okay. Roku.
So he was having trouble with that. All right, then what happened?
What happened?
Yeah, tonight.
Yeah, then he started throwing plates and silverware and stuff at me. Mm-hmm. And I'm not going to deal with that. I'm not going to sit at home and have my father try to wreck me, man, you know?
Okay, and then what happened?
And then I started, you know, I started telling him, look, I'm trying to do everything I can, man, to help you out, man. And it ain't never enough, man. Mm-hmm. It just ain't never enough.
Okay.
So I tried leaving. And then he still starts throwing stuff at me. Nope, I didn't do nothing, man.
Did you come at him with a screwdriver?
Nope.
Okay. Did you ever put your hands on him tonight?
No, I didn't.
Did he put his hands on you?
Yes, he put his hands on me.
How?
How?
Yes.
He started grabbing me and choking me and shit, man.
So when did this happen? You just said he started throwing stuff at you, and then you got in your car and left. So what? Start over. What happened? So you guys got an argument over TV?
Yeah, over the TV. Then he started choking me and started throwing stuff at me. So that's when I tried to leave. And then he said, oh, no, you ain't going nowhere, man. You ain't going nowhere.
Where did this all happen in the house?
This all happened today.
I'm sure where that didn't happen. Did it happen inside the house, outside the house?
Inside the house.
It's 7 a.m., 7 p.m., 10:30 p.m.?
Yep. 9 p.m. right now. 10 o'clock.
One of the first questions I asked you was how much you had to drink, right? And you told me nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah, but how come I can smell it from it?
I don't have it.
So, all right, here's what I want to do, man. I'm going to have you get out real quick, and I'm just trying to make sure you're okay to drive, all right? I'm going to put you through a few tasks, okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, you guys need to do the laceration here, right there.
So, let's step out, go up this way. I'm going to find my car. So, I'm gonna have you step right here. All right, turn around and face me, man.
Yeah.
Just somewhere in front of my car,
No se desempeñó muy bien en las pruebas, se saltó instrucciones aquí y allá. A pesar de que se trataba de una zona gris, el hombre se negó a consentir una prueba de alcoholemia preliminar, lo que puso fin a este ejercicio. Los oficiales utilizaron su buen juicio para esposar al hombre y lo transportaron a la cárcel local.
Okay. Put your foot down.
Yep.
All right, keep your hands to your side. I'll read you something, this Michigan law requires you to submit to a preliminary breath test upon the request of a peace officer, somebody like myself, okay? Your refusal to submit to such request shall result in you being charged with a civil infraction penalty up to $150 fine. Will you take a PBT?
No.
Okay. All right. I'm going to have you turn around, sir. Put your hands behind your back. All right. And then lock your hands like you're praying. Alright, as of right now, you're being placed because of the domestic with your dad, placed under arrest for that, and then the OWI. Spread your feet. Spread them.
El hijo fue acusado por conducir bajo los efectos del alcohol y violencia doméstica. Para poner fin a esta situación de violencia doméstica, pasaremos a nuestro último sospechoso, una mujer joven que es increíblemente tonta y recibió cargos criminales gracias a eso. Alexandria. Era el 18 de septiembre de 2022 cuando la policía de Maitland recibió una llamada de emergencia. Un padre había llamado a los agentes como último recurso cuando no pudo sacar a su hija del coche. La joven se sentía insoportablemente engreída y comunicarse con ella sería lo más difícil que la policía tendría que hacer ese día. Veamos qué pasó.
Why isn't she getting out?
I don't know. She's got a lot of problems in life and can't seem to solve them. I offered to give her a ride, and now...
This is my dad, and I think he's, I don't know exactly what's going on, but he has the key to the car, so I'm just waiting on him to get out of the building.
You're waiting on him to what?
To get out of the building, to come drive the car.
He just parked us here, so I don't know.
Yeah, but you know he doesn't have to drive you anywhere, but it's his car. He doesn't have to take you anywhere if he doesn't want to.
I understand. Well, he already took me here, so I'm in the car. I'd like to, you know, go back to my house whenever... He's ready, basically. So I'm just sitting in the car.
Okay, but do you realize that if he doesn't want to take you, you have to get out because it's his car, it's his property?
I don't think so. I think
I'm letting you know.
No,
but that's how that works.
Okay, well, I'm gonna be sitting here. So, whenever he's ready.
He doesn't want to drive. You don't want to drive her home?
Oh, I do not.
I think he might be having some sort of like early dementia or something, but he is not acting like himself. We were just going to go to Starbucks, and then he said that he had to go, and I can't remember if he said he needed to take a package somewhere.
He had me bring her down here. I got her a couple of gift cards because she doesn't have a job.
He did. He just got me a gift card.
She's supposed to be in a rehab facility, but somehow managed to get kicked out of it and showed up back at the apartment. So I felt sorry for her. My mistake. Gave her more money, gave her more things to do, took her here so she could get food. Not only did she not get food, she refused to get out of the car, and now she refuses to get out of it at all.
I'm just trying to spend the day with them, or go out and run errands. We're just trying to run errands.
La joven se mostró muy indiferente con los agentes y estaba claro que no se tomaba nada de esto en serio. Pensó que tenía derecho a exigir que su padre se la llevara a casa, pero se lo veía muy por encima. Hizo afirmaciones terribles sobre el estado de su padre, todas ellas descaradamente falsas, y nos estamos enterando de que ella es una gran mentirosa.
So you're trespassing.
So I go on Ubers.
Okay. Ubers with the permission of the person. He does not want you in his car. You're trespassing. We can play this game, but you're gonna get arrested. I mean, that's literally how it's gonna be, or you could just step out of the car. Like, I'm not trying to be mean to you, but I'm trying to explain something to you, and you're not really willing to listen.
You explained it to me, but I would like to shut my door now.
I'm not doing that. It's not your door. It's not your car.
Okay, I'll just ignore that then.
Just get out, Alex. You're making a show
out of it. His door? I'm not trying to. I'm not trying to make a show out of it. It's just, like, it's frustrating.
You see the problem? I didn't want to touch her at this point.
No, I understand. I mean, it's definitely your car, and you want her out of the car. Can you understand, please?
I shouldn't have agreed to do it. She's had long
64
problems enabling this bad behavior, and it's my fault. I enabled one more time.
La mujer no creía que su padre presentara cargos por allanamiento de morada en su contra, e incluso después de que los agentes intentaran explicarle las cosas, sin cesar estaba claro que no entendía. Llegó al extremo de intentar cerrar la puerta a la fuerza en las narices de los agentes y estaba a punto de meterse en serios problemas.
So do you want to press charges for trespassing?
I do.
I mean, you can't just press charges like that.
You can.
No, you can't.
So, do you want to get out of the car or not?
Don't you guys have anything better to do today?
We actually do.
Yeah, like, so I don't know what you guys
really
are
like
up to.
For you to
why
get out?
Why don't you drive around in your cars?
I don't want to take a ride to the jail.
I would love to. I love riding around places. I love going on errands. I love driving. Love all of it.
This is going to be one of those situations when you go down to the jail, people are like, what are you in for? And you say, because I wouldn't get out of the car. People are going to be like, that's a stupid reason to go to jail. I mean, really, there's really not a really good reason to go to jail, but that's really stupid.
Well, it's more stupid of you guys, because it's just a lot of paperwork and a lot of trouble.
We don't want to be here, but we're public servants. We've been called here.
You're not a servant.
We've been summoned here. So we're here to solve a problem. Unfortunately...
Do you have a payroll?
The problem is that you're in the car. It's to solve the problem...
I don't think there's not a solution. There isn't a solution.
The solution is that you step out. Either stand over here, you could sit, there's a bench over here, there's a bench there, there's a bench over there. Okay, yeah, go ahead and stand out of the car.
No, I stepped out, it's fine. Please allow me to.
No, you're not closing the door.
I don't want to shut it on you. I don't want to, like...
I can promise you you're not going
to
shut it on you.
Please stop touching this car, because it's not your car.
It's not yours either.
Well, that's okay.
All right, you're going to end up...
No.
You're going to end up...
You are.
Step on out. I'm just going to pull you out, I mean... At the end of the day, you're going to come out of the car, so do we have to make this harder? I don't want to.
Don't pull my arm out of its socket.
Well, then please step out.
Don't touch me.
We'll just get the statement. We're not in a hurry.
Okay. Don't touch me. Don't molest me. Please.
What's going to end up happening is...
Ponerle las esposas a esta mujer no resultó calmarla, y tuvieron que subirle a la fuerza a la parte trasera del coche de patrulla. Incluso entonces no dejó de sorprender a los agentes y hacerles preguntas inútiles. Estamos bastante seguros de que los agentes abandonaron esta escena con un dolor de cabeza totalmente terrible. Dos de ellos también recibieron patadas de ella, y su dramatismo persistiría hasta llegar a la cárcel.
No, I'm not going to. Why?
Put your hands behind your back. You're under arrest.
I'm under cardiac arrest.
You're placed under arrest for trespassing and resisting.
You can't do that.
We can.
No, you're not going to. You're not going to. Stop. Stop.
I wish we didn't have to.
Stop.
I wish we didn't have
Stop.
To. We tried to work it out with you.
Stop.
We for whatever reason you decided
to cancel. Stop policing me.
Bye, Alex.
I'm sorry that this is the way that it had to go.
This is not the law. This isn't lawful. I'm not resisting. No, stop searching me.
I have to search you.
You're molesting me. You're sexually assaulting me.
Stop.
You are sexually assaulting me. No.
She's not.
Yes,
no, she
is.
Not.
Dad, help me.
I am not helping you.
Please help me. Please help me.
Stop.
Get off me.
Stop.
Get off me.
Stop.
Stop.
Resisting.
Stop.
Now you're getting a felony.
Get off me. Stop touching me.
Stop resisting.
Stop touching me.
Stop resisting.
Stop touching me.
He's mentally ill.
Stop touching me. Oh, my arm.
Sit in the
Stop
car.
It.
Sit in the car.
Stop it.
Can you please pick up your license in the car? I don't want to have to help you.
I got it. Sorry.
Get off me. Stop touching me.
Close the door.
Alexandria la acusaron de allanamiento ilegal y agresión a un agente de la ley. Quédate para ver más listas locas y echar un vistazo a lo que los agentes de policía tienen que afrontar todos los días.